Hello and welcome to Recombu. My name is Peter Phelps and today I'm going to be unboxing the OPPO A16s. This is a budget phone which costs less than £150 now. So let's see what you get for your money. Right, so let's dive into that box. There we go, and once I lift the lid, first thing underneath that is this cardboard envelope, and so we'll open that up to see what's inside. So there's a SIM card key. Below that we've got the usual kind of warranty and safety information that you've come to expect, and there is a clear plastic case, which is nice to see, especially on a phone of this budget. So it should save the back of your phone from a couple of scrapes and knocks that it might otherwise pick up. Here is the phone itself, of course. We'll take that out and return to it in just a minute. And then underneath that, we've got a charger. And in this little section, we've got both a USB-C cable and a pair of earphones, which is quite a rare sight to see these days, but there you go. And it's obviously got 3.5 millimeter jack. So I'll box that up and get back to the main event, which is of course the phone itself. So here is the device. I'll just get it out of its little plastic pouch. There you go. I'll peel this label off so you can get a better look. The rear panel, and as you can see, it's quite a lustrous shade of blue, a deep blue there that's very reflective, but does look quite classy, quite nice. I'm not sure if it will survive greasy fingerprints all that well, but for the moment it does look eye-catching, that's for sure. In terms of physical dimensions, this one measures 163.8 millimeters by 75.6 millimeters and it's 8.4 millimeters thick whilst weighing 190 grams. It certainly seems like a manageably sized device to me. As you might have spotted, there's a fingerprint scanner on the side, not on the screen of course, but it does have face unlock too. Within the phone you'll find space for two SIM cards, and at the bottom here we've got a USB-C connector and yes, that 3.5 millimeter headphone jack too. Now in this camera module you'll see it's triple sensor. The main sensor is a 13 megapixel one with f2.2 aperture, 80 degree field of view, and it has got autofocus as well. When you're shooting video, you can get 1080p footage at 30 frames per second. Then there are two accompanying sensors. One's a 2 megapixel depth sensor, and the other one is a 2 megapixel macro sensor. These both have fixed focus, they don't have autofocus. As for the selfie camera, you've got an 8 megapixel sensor right at the top, housed in a little notch there. So I'm gonna get this phone started up, get all the software up and running, and show you around. Okay, so now we've got the software all set up. As you can see, it runs on Color OS. This variant is Color OS 11.1, and it's based on Android 11. So let's click through to get started. So this is the phone on startup. As you can see, I've only just clicked through. And already you can see there are a lot of pre-installed apps present on here, from PUBG to LinkedIn to Booking, Amazon Music and more. I consider this to be a load of bloatware, to be honest. It's not really what I want to see in a phone, especially on a cheaper budget phone. I prefer to see stripped down basic software and then to leave it up to me for what apps that I would like to download or not, rather than having it clogged up with these kind of things. I'll just dive into the settings and show you around there. Okay, so in terms of Wi-Fi, this does actually support dual band Wi-Fi at 2.4 gigahertz and 5 gigahertz, and it's got Bluetooth 5.0 as well. More good news is that it supports NFC, which is especially useful if you're making contactless payments, for instance, via your phone. For the display, you're not gonna find an enhanced refresh rate here. It's just got 60 hertz refresh rate, and also the touch sampling rate is 60 hertz as well. So it's not the most responsive screen for gaming, for instance, but that's unlikely to surprise you because it is in the budget spectrum after all. It does have an eye comfort shield here if you want to reduce the amount of blue light that's emitted by the display. The screen itself is an LCD panel, so it's going to lack the same contrast that you're going to get from the OLEDs, and it measures 6.52 inches across. The resolution is just 720p, so that's HD+. It's not as detailed as the full HD+ resolutions that you might get on slightly pricier phones, and so you will notice pixels and so on. It's not completely sharp as you might want. The refresh rate is 60 Hz, same as the sample touch rate. So it's not that responsive, not that smooth either, but if you're not used to a high refresh rate, you won't probably find that to be too disturbing. The screen to body ratio, as you can see here, is 88.7%. So it's got a little chin at the bottom, but apart from that, it's mostly all screen at the front here. The brightness of this panel is a maximum of 480 nits. Battery capacity, by the way, for this phone is 5000 mAh typically, which is a fairly large capacity, so hopefully that'll see you through all the usage that you need. This phone runs on MediaTek Helio G35 CPU, which is 8-core. It's got a max speed of 2.4 GHz. As you might expect, again, given the price, it hasn't got 5G connectivity, but it has got 4G, evidently. There aren't too many camera modes to play around with here. You've got the macro mode, to, which uses the 2-megapixel macro sensor on the back, and you have got pro mode as well, if you want to be a bit more choosy with what you shoot. But for the most part, it's a fairly basic app. It does have night mode, so we'll check out and see whether that can effectively reduce the kind of noise that you might get when you're shooting photos in darker settings. So that was the OPPO A16s. It is quite a cheap phone, clocking in at under £150, so inevitably you're going to find some compromises here, say for instance in the screen specs, the performance levels, the camera sensors, but nonetheless, do you think that this could do a good job for you based on what you've seen so far? Let us know what you thought in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for more video content from Recombu.